Hi, I'm Fiona from DIY Digital, and yesterday I stumbled across Google's own search engine optimization starters guide, and I thought, that's really interesting, hearing it from Google themselves. What are they saying we need to do as business owners to optimize our website? Well, I went there, and it's 8,500 words, and if you print it out on a Word document, it's 33 pages. 33 pages, and it's a starter's guide. That's phenomenal. We can't get through that. So here it is. Here's the SEO for Dummies in 15 minutes based on Google's own article. So I've taken the lead from what they're saying. I've summarized it, digested it, and I'm going to about to give it to you in 15 minutes. SEO for Dummies, here we come. Right, the first thing is they have the contents. Their contents are getting started, help Google find your content, tell Google which pages shouldn't be crawled, help Google and users understand your content, manage your appearance in Google search results, organize your site hierarchy, optimize your content, optimize your images, make your site mobile friendly, promote your website, analyze your search performance and user behavior, and an appendix with some URLs. So that's their contents. We're going to follow those same contents. So they're getting started chapter. To begin with, tells you about the lingo. I'm not going to use any lingo in this video, so we'll skip that. It also then asks the question, are you on Google? Well, Google yourself. Google your business name. If you're called Adelaide Dance Shoes, Google Adelaide Dance Shoes. Do you come up? Well, if you come up, you know you're on Google. There's a good way to check it. If you don't come up, two things to do. Either check with your website developer, ask them, how come I'm not coming up? You'll have to hand it back to them. Or here's a tip. Get your website, the link, on another website. Yeah? So if you belong to a local business association, let's say, then ask that business association to list your business and ensure that your website link is on it. Or your LinkedIn profile. Put it on your LinkedIn profile. Get a link from somewhere else to your website. Now, they also talk about the techie thing, Google Search Console. Google Search Console is a bit techie. We're not going to cover it here, but website developers know about it, and so they will investigate that option for you if you need that. Do you need an SEO expert? They actually cover this, the Google cover this in their starter's guide. And they sit on the fence. Basically, they say, well, you might not. Basically, it's one of two things, guys. You either do need an SEO person to help you out, or you need to be prepared to put the learning in yourself, learning and practice and time. And then you can optimize your own website. It's one or the other, else it just doesn't get done. Yeah? Okay. So help Google find the content is their second section. If you like, and it's a repeat of their first section, so no need to cover that. Okay, next section is tell Google which pages shouldn't be crawled. Well, too techie, this is a starter's guide, this is SEO for Dummies, that's advanced. Help Google and users understand your content. Now, here's the nitty-gritty. We're going to get really into stuff in this one. Help Google and users understand your content. You think it would be easy, wouldn't you? You think this would be so straightforward, but how many business owners do I come across that get this wrong? They really do. So here's a couple of things. Call a spade, and call a bucket. You do not call it a digging device with a handle. It's a spade. You do not call it a water holding unit. It's a bucket. Okay, so many business owners want to be smart. Here's an example that makes sense to you. Are you a teacher or an educator? Here's a look at Google Trends. You can see here the blue line is teacher, the red line is educator. Lots more people searching on the term teacher than they are searching on the term educator. So if you want to be found in Google for the services you provide, don't describe your services as an educator. Describe them as a teacher. Here's doctor versus health professional. Here's moisturizer versus body care. Okay, don't we all like to call it body care or skin care or something else? You know what, folks? everybody's still calling it moisturizer. Okay, here's coffee versus latte. Okay, we can be nice and trendy with latte if we want, but coffee is going to get your site optimized because that's what people are searching for in Google. So when we say help Google and users understand your content, find your content, use the words that people use in real life. Okay? So business owners want to be too smart often. Please don't be. State the bleeding obvious. Okay? Now, also in this section, Google tells us not to have our website as a muddle. Don't have clutter. Think of a real estate agent when they come into your home and they say, oh, get rid of that and get rid of that. Get rid of the clutter. Same with a website. Get rid of the clutter. Look at this picture. It's messy. It's untidy. Look at that picture. Oh, that's nice, isn't it? Now, somebody with this picture here might say, oh, but I would be able to find my whatever you're looking for. Yeah, it's not about you finding it. It's about the visitor finding it. Okay, it's about having an accommodation B&B and you're welcoming people into this room. If you welcome this into this room, this kitchen here, they'd take a stab at the dark and find the knife and forks. They don't need to be out on the bench to see. They need to be in the drawer that they expect them to be in, that most kitchens have them in. So go by the conventions of what other websites are doing and people will be able to understand where to find stuff. Now, let's have a look at some real websites. Let's have a look at the plumber's website. It's got 24/7 emergency plumbing. Where is it? Where is this plumber? Because that's one of the first things you want to know when you go to a plumber's site. Oh, okay. Right up there in small white font, it says Adelaide. Now, is that helping users or Google find the content? Not really. I don't think so. State the bleeding obvious. And when you're a plumber, one of the obvious things you want to state is what location that you're in. Now, here's another plumbing website. On their navigation menu, plumbing. Doesn't actually help me because I know I'm at a plumbing website. It does help me that it says drains and services and water heaters and gas. That helps me understand what type of services you offer. But plumbing is redundant on this menu because we're already at a plumbing site. Here they do have Adelaide up nice and high so I can tell which area that they're going to service. So that's quite nice. Here's another one that has Adelaide up and high. And yeah, they haven't got the services listed, but they've got a clear services button. And when I drop down, I can see blocked drains, hot water system, rainwater tanks. So nice and easy. Nice and easy on that one. Okay, let's go to their mobile version because, of course, mobile is super important, especially for plumbers and what have you. So here we come back to this one, and now I can't tell at all where they are. I only have one choice, gas fitting. The business owners love sliders, and I can see this gas fitting one's going to slide across, maybe say something else. The first one says gas fitting, the second one says, I don't know, bathroom renovations, and the next one says emergency plumbing, whatever it says. I have to do the work. It's not giving it to me. And this may seem small fry, but this is what Google means when they say, let Google and users understand. They want it really straight away. So straight away, I get gas fitting, but I don't get the other services. And you're local. Great. Local to where? I don't know, San Diego, Birmingham, Wellington. Where exactly are we local to? Because you know what, guys? I can't tell from that. The next one, that's got a really good click-to-call phone number, really up high, great. Fast Adelaide Plumbers, I can see straight away on their mobile, they're Adelaide. This next one here, book online, so that's what they want you to do rather than ring. I had to scroll down to get Adelaide, but I didn't have to scroll that far. So, you know, we're talking about being really, really obvious. And that's what Google talks about in this paragraph when it says, help users and Google understand your content. Keep it simple, stupid. The KISS principle. This section also talks about a whole bunch of coding stuff, description meta tags, structured data markup, heading tags, too technical for a starter's guide, I believe, and certainly too technical for SEO for Dummies. So that's out. But I will say this, if you have a Wix site or a Shopify site, or you have a plugin on your WordPress site that helps you with SEO, often they're saying put the meta description here or a snippet here or put a page title there. They'll call call it slightly different things, a preview, a Google preview, something or other. Use what your platform is kind of prompting you to do, because it's probably and possibly covering off some of this stuff here. So certainly investigate that depending on the website platform you're using, Wix, Shopify, WordPress, whatever. Well, the next topic is manage your appearance in Google search results. Well, basically they're repeating all this stuff about description meta tags. So, basically we'll leave it at that. Organize your site hierarchy. This is another one that business owners get really trapped under, but it is your job to do it. So, okay, let's give the example of footwear. Let's say you sell footwear, and let's say there's different types of footwear. Let's say there's boots, sandals, evening wear, work wear, work shoes, evening shoes. Let's just say that's the four. And let's say there's a pair of shoes that fit in both the evening shoes and the work shoes. They could be worn for either. So you're going, oh, well, I don't know where to put it. Make a decision. If you can't make a decision, how do you expect Google to, or how do you expect the user to? Now, you might be able to allocate it a sub or secondary category later on, whatever, but in the initial stages, you need to decide what is the hierarchy of information on your site. Okay, that's your decision. So be bold, be courageous, make a decision. Alrighty, now optimize your content. Okay, here's a couple of easy tips, and Google give it away in their starter's guide. I'm just summarizing it here for you. Make it useful, make it interesting. Make your content useful and interesting, not so hard. Make it easy to read. Okay, not long words, not long sentences, unless you are an academic, you know, you're actually in that, and your customers as well are into that academic, because you don't want to appear dumb to them. But for most business owners, make it easy reading. Short sentences, short words, really it comes down to that. That helps optimize your content. Format your content with headings and bullets and paragraphs. Lay it out so that it looks easy to read, yeah? So make it read well and make it look good. That's optimizing your content. Optimizing your images. Lots of things we can do here. Don't load up really big images, because that's going to slow your site down. So your image size matters, but also your image naming. Okay, so when we upload an image, it might be by default called Canon123.jpg, because we took the photo with a Canon, you know, camera, and that's just how it came. Change it before uploading it to your website as Boy in Tree or Adelaide in Autumn or something that the image actually represents. Yeah? So call your images by proper names and words that make sense to the image. So that's optimizing your images, yeah? Make your site mobile friendly. Okay, guys, we've heard it, and Google is saying it in their starter's guide. If you have a website, people still need to pinch and zoom to see that website, to read the text. You just got to get a new website. That's just the bottom line. There's no easy fix. You got to get a new website. So make it mobile friendly. You want white space around the buttons to click, and around the, if you've got links to click, have a little bit of a white space so people can click. You know, think about it as being thumb friendly. Yeah. You know, because people are on their mobile phone with their thumb. So think about your mobile site being a thumb friendly, and that'll do it for you. Not too busy and scroll friendly, yeah? Promote your website. Now, this is what Google is telling us to do. Don't rely entirely on Google. If you're not promoting your own site, why should Google care? Yeah, so that means, you know, in your emails, hey, have you visited my website page, or on your LinkedIn profile, or the business association I mentioned before, or your social media channels, on your business cards. Get your website seen and reason for people to visit it and read the material on it outside of just search engine optimization. Yeah, it might even be paying for ads to go to your ad to your website. However you do it, they expect that you're going to promote this website off Google in some other way as well, and that will help your Google rankings. Yeah. And down to just two last sections, analyze your search performance and user behavior. They go back to talking about Google Search Console. I don't think Google Search Console is for beginners, certainly not for starters, and certainly not for dummies. So we're just not going to go there. But I will say this, Google Analytics, it is free, and you should hook it up to your website because that is really quite useful. That's also a bit hard to get used to, but just these two stats, right, just the two figures that you're after, you can get lots more from Google Analytics. But let's just concentrate on two for the dummies. Okay, one, how many people are coming to your site? Is it 50 or 500 a month? How many? And then where are they coming from? Are they coming from social media? Are they coming organically? Are they coming from paid ads? So just focus on those two statistics to begin with. Learn more later on, but they will help you understand the performance of your website. And additional resources, if you've got down to words 8,000, 8,500, you're up to the additional resources where they give you 7 additional resources and 62 links that you can go for further reading if you like. But if not, you don't obviously have to go there. So I'll give the link to the Google Starters Guide in below. So you can go there for yourself and read the full article. But I hope you've enjoyed this SEO for Dummies starters guide, my own version of it, summarized from the Google article. If you've liked this video, please do subscribe. Hit that subscribe button, please do, because I'd love to have you as a subscriber. And please do feel free to visit us at diydigital.com.au.